I'm gonna give an update about some things that have happened recently. I'm no longer employed. I no longer have a full-time job now due to some things that have happened to me within the past few months. So I got prescribed some medications for various ailments, for various mental ailments to be more specific. I've dealt with depression, anxiety, and insomnia for quite some time, and so I went to a doctor and I got prescribed some medications to deal with them. I was prescribed bupropion for depression. Bupropion is kind of like Adderall. It's a norepinephrine dopamine reuptake inhibitor. Kind of makes you a bit more energetic. And it did that for me. And it's also used for smoking cessation because it is also a nicotinic acetylcholine, I don't know if that's how you pronounce it, a nicotinic acetylcholine receptor antagonist. So it helps reduce cravings for smoking. So there's that. So if you're depressed and are dealing with and want to quit smoking, then bupropion is probably something that you want to look into. And like I said, that was one thing I was prescribed. I was prescribed 150 milligrams of that. And it was bupropion XL, which I was prescribed, which was extended length. I think that's what the XL stands for. I took 150 milligrams of that during the first 2 weeks, once a day. And then after 2 weeks, I increased the dosage up to twice a day, one in the morning, one in the evening after I would get off work. For anxiety, I was prescribed hydroxyzine, 25 milligrams to be taken as needed every 8 hours. And for insomnia, I was prescribed trazodone, 50 milligrams to take nightly, once or twice if need be, if I need more than one. So I found the hydroxyzine is pretty helpful. You know, it calms me down, kind of sedates me a little bit. It isn't too terribly sedating. It was a bit less sedating than I expected, which was very good. But it's helped me a lot with regards to like slowing down my thoughts, which is kind of something that hap a bad thing that happens when I'm dealing with anxiety. In addition, the trazodone pretty much always knocks me out, puts me on my ass, heavily sedating drug. Which is good, helps me knock me out. Though in the morning I've always found that it doesn't really, that I kind of feel some residual sleepiness. But it's not too bad. Usually I get like some caffeine later on in the day, and it'll get me really nice and pumped up and ready for the day. And then there's the bupropion. So the good things about the bupropion. Bupropion, you know, help me be more wakeful. It definitely helped me be a bit more wakeful. Definitely made me a bit more alert, for sure. It was it did help. It gave me a bit more energy. One of the things that I found, one of the worst things about my depression that I found is is just being tired all the time. Feeling like I have no energy and such. And during the first 2 weeks, at least, it made me a bit more motivated as well. And like I said, it's kind of like an antidepressant Adderall. I'm not used Adderall, but from what I've heard, it's very, it helps people concentrate, and that's, you know, why they prescribed it anyways for ADHD. In fact, I think bupropion is used for ADHD off label, as well as for depression, major depression, and smoking and quitting smoking. However, after I increased my dosage, I began to notice something was wrong, basically. Now, I've always dealt with some pretty weird thoughts, but and normally I've been able to push them to the side and focus, especially at work. You know, when I'm at work, usually it was work is kind of like one of those places where it's like I go there and it's like I'm able to kind of like where I'm like focused on other things, and it's like I'm able to focus on those things. My tasks at work and everything else is just left out the window. However, on bupropion, it was like all that all these intrusive thoughts and shit were pushed to the forefront, constantly thinking about them and shit, which became a problem. I became unable to concentrate at work. My performance drastically decreased by a pretty big amount. My boss was getting mad at me, kind of yelling at me every week, which also further amplified the situation. It did not help what I was dealing with. And I was about to be put on a performance improvement plan, or PIP for short, up to the time when I gave notice. I gave notice on the 20th of February during our weekly one-on-one meetings. I just told my boss, you know, look, I'm dealing with things right now. I'm dealing with some serious things right now. I'm not able to focus. I think something is seriously wrong. I gotta leave. I'm sorry, but I gotta leave. And he was like, okay. I gave a 2-week notice. I had originally thought about just quitting right then and there, but I gave 2 weeks, but he said, you can go home. We'll send you home, and you'll get paid for the next 2 weeks up till the 5th of March, which has already passed. And basically, I'm unemployed right now. I'm not really doing much. Though, actually, I do have this little thing with the U exam, with this company called U exams, where I provide testing accommodations to people with disabilities. Usually those things run to about 18 to 20 an hour. They're infrequent. I've got one coming up. I did one a couple weeks ago. It was only 2 hours long. But I complete early, and the cool thing is when you complete early, you know, you get paid for the entire thing. So if you're in the middle of something like right now, and you're looking for something to do right now, earn a bit of extra cash, I highly recommend it. Because usually what I do for that is usually I'll read answers to people, like if someone is blind or something, I'll read the answers to them, or record their answers for them into a computer. So it's a good way. It's nothing for me to live off of, but it's a decent contingency plan for the time being until I can go back to work, until I can find another job. I was planning to start looking at the beginning of next month, but I'm trying to, you know, just kind of like get things together and stuff mentally and everything. But in the meantime, I've been doing like a bit of volunteering, kind of like dedicating my time towards improving my community. I've been going around my neighborhood and picking up garbage along the streets in my neighborhood. A lot of people have noticed, and they've complimented on me on that. You know, they'd be like, is this all? One guy actually, on last Wednesday, when I was going around, he was like, is that all you gotta do? And I was like, well, I'm unemployed right now, and I don't want to sit around doing nothing, so I just want to kind of volunteer my time and, you know, just be the neighborhood beautification committee, if you will. And he was like, oh, there's nothing wrong with that. You know, there's definitely nothing wrong. And if you've watched my previous video, you probably, you know, saw that I bought a house recently. And you might be wondering, why the fuck did you quit your job after you bought a fucking house? Well, I don't want to go into too much detail, but I've got everything taken care of, basically, with regards to finances and stuff. I've got plenty of savings. I'm a penny pincher. I have pretty much little to no debt. I do have 2 credit cards. I actually did apply for an Amazon Prime credit card for use with Amazon, and I got a $2,200 credit line. I have my other credit card got like $10,000 credit line. Though, you know, I don't want to live off of credit cards and fuck my credit score into the dirt. But it's, you know, if things come up, I've got that, and I've got plenty of savings. I'm fine for a couple months, I think, but eventually I'm probably gonna, if I don't find something in my field, I'm probably just gonna try and take anything. And it's at this point where I'm pissed off that I can't go back to UPS and work as a package handler there again. I worked there during the summer of 2016 for 2.5 months before I took the internship with the company I was previously working for. But I can't go back to UPS apparently, which sucks so much, but it is what it is, and If not, I can probably go walk to one of the convenience stores nearby and ask for an application or something. I mean, it's a shitty situation, but I couldn't concentrate and I couldn't and I felt and everything was just I just felt a steady decline mentally. I'm off the bupropion now, but the other two surprisingly haven't really been doing anything crazy, but the bupropion just I think from what I was able to tell it was the culprit behind everything. It's been implicated in like mania and psychosis and things like that, and it was and I talked to my doctor and he was like, yeah, it sounds like, you know, maybe this wasn't such a good idea, but it is what it is. I can find another job. Even if I don't in my field, probably find another job in my field, I think. If I don't, then I'll do something else, but I do want to try and find work in my field. I haven't told anybody in my family about this. In fact, I kind of feel bad that I haven't done so yet, and probably just gonna, I hate to say it, but I'm probably just gonna tell them I got laid off for other reasons or something like that. It sucks, but it is what it is. But I'll be fine, I think. I've got plenty of savings. I can live off of that for a few more months, and if not, then I'll find anything. I'll walk to the nearby labor ready and work construction and shit. I may be skinny, but I'm not weak. I mean, I worked at UPS as a package handler. If you've ever worked for that job or you've heard of it, then you know that that job is tough as fuck. But for me personally, it wasn't physical. The difficulty wasn't really physical that much, honestly. It was more mental, really. That job will wear you down mentally, but I was able to tough it out for at least 2.5 months. But you know, I can't go back there. They said if you leave before a month, you can never leave before a year. My apologies. If you leave that job for a year, you can't go back. And it sucks because it's like they give you benefits and stuff after a year, like medical and shit. I had it in a 401k. I had those at my last job. But I can't go back to UPS ever again. But I don't think that job is gonna be around for much longer given automation and shit. So. It is what it is. I'll start looking soon. Hopefully I can get something, but if not, then I'll just throw darts everywhere. That's all. Take care of your mental health. Be careful with pharmaceuticals. Adio.